So now look at this. x to the power 3 is multiplied with x power 3, so x power 6 plus x power 3 into x power 4, x power 3 into 1, x cube. So this is 0, x power 4 and x square, because this is 0, this is 0, x power 4 as it is, plus x square, this is also 0. So now what am I getting? 1, x cube is not there, x square plus x is there, they are just zeros. So this is not available. So now you are multiplying it with x power 4 plus x into x, x square plus x into 1, x. X power 4 and 4 becomes 0. You are left with x square plus x, which is a remainder. Now how do you write x square plus x? 0. 1, 0. This is 0, 1, 0. As you can see, 0, 1, and 0. X square plus x is 0, 1, and x power 0 is not there, so it is 0. So the code word is this, and the remainder is this. So same logic is applied here too in performing this. So, x power 7, x power 5 plus x square plus x plus 1. How did you get this? This is x power 6. So, what do you have is, let me write here once again, x power 6 plus x cube plus x square plus x. So, this is x power 1, x power 6. 0, same thing. So 1 0 0 1 3 0, same. This is how polynomial division is applied. So is most often represented not as a string of ones and zeros, but it is expressed as a polynomial. These are the examples. So one more example: x is 6 is 0, 4 is 0, 3 is 0. This is how we represent a polynomial. Now, the degree of the polynomial, you all know the degree of the polynomial is the highest power. So, this is 12 here, this is 16 here, this is again 16, this is 32. This is an interesting example. Suppose our data, I'll just do this and then leave it. Suppose our data is a list of 4 bit numbers that we want to send to our destination. So, in addition to sending these numbers, you are sending 4 bits of information. So, in addition to sending these numbers, we send the sum of numbers also. Then, for example, if the numbers are 7, 11, 12, 0, and 6, 4 bit numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 5 is 20 numbers is what we are sending. Then, what is the sum here? The sum is 7 plus 11 plus 12 plus 6. 7 plus 11 is 18, 18 plus 12 30, 30 plus 6 is 56. So in addition to these numbers, you are sending the 36 number. If this is the sum of the original numbers, the receiver adds 5 numbers and compares the result with the sum. So the sender is sending 5 bits, the receiver is also receiving 5 bits. If they are same, then receiver assumes there is no error, accepts the 5 numbers. If the sum happens to be different, then there is an error. So this procedure is referred to as check sum. This procedure of detection is known as check sum method of error detection and error correction mechanism. So with this, we will continue this in the next class.